American Family News on the Hour. I'm Chad Groening. The only New York gubernatorial debate between incumbent Democratic Governor Kathy Hochul and New York Republican Congressman Lee Zeldin took place at Pace University Tuesday night. Congressman Zeldin said he's in favor of certain election integrity measures.
I believe that we should have voter ID in our state. I believe that we should have voter ID in all 50 states. I oppose ballot harvesting. I believe that we have a principle of one person, one vote, and that is a principle that belongs to a United States citizen.
The debate was hosted by Spectrum News NY1. And Tuesday marked the first and only debate between Pennsylvania Senate candidates Dr. Mehmet Oz and Lieutenant Governor John Fetterman on the topic of crime. Oz blamed Fetterman and accused him of defunding the police and supporting clemency.
Part of the problem is that we have taken away the ability of police to do their job, and that's on John Fetterman.
Oz also seized on Fetterman's policies on immigration and his support for President Joe Biden. Border officials say a record number of migrants were apprehended along the U.S.-Mexico border in the month of September, adding to an already record-breaking number of migrants apprehended in the last fiscal year. Fox's Jessica Rosenthal reports.
Customs and Border Protection said in September they encountered 227,000 migrants, bringing the fiscal year total to a record-breaking nearly 2.4 million migrant apprehensions. This doesn't include the estimated 600,000 known gotaways. Texas Republican Congressman Dan Crenshaw told the Fox News Rundown podcast, if the GOP takes control of the House, they will press for information from the Biden administration about the border.
The cartels themselves are funneling fentanyl into our country and lacing street drugs with basically a poison. And, you know, we're not acting like it's an act of war, but it is an act of war.
98 migrants apprehended between ports of entry in the past fiscal year had names that matched those on the terrorist screening database. Jessica Rosenthal, Fox News.
The Defense Department is answering questions on, quote, false reports coming out of Russia about the war in Ukraine. Fox's Kristen Goodwin has that story.
Pentagon Press Secretary Brigadier General Pat Ryder says Russian allegations that Ukraine is building a dirty bomb are false, noting several times the U.S. sees no evidence to suggest Russia intends to employ nuclear weapons or a dirty bomb and hasn't seen any need to change its strategic forces.
We have no indication right now that Russia has made a decision to employ nuclear chem bio weapons at this time. But again, it's something that we'll continue to monitor very closely.
Noting consequences to those types of capabilities have been communicated at a variety of levels, adding the U.S. will continue to keep lines of communication open with allies, Ukraine, and Russian officials. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
One might think with recent reports showing the nation's students falling far behind in critical subjects such as math and reading, teachers would be very concerned. But those were not the subjects dealt with at a recent teachers' conference in Washington State. Instead, the conference featured workshops with titles such as Decolonizing Minds, Intersectional Feminism, and Whiteness. AFN's Bob Kellogg has more.
Supported by the Seattle Education Association, this year's Northwest Teaching for Social Justice Conference was supposed to strengthen public education. Marie Fisher of Project 21 says this is about indoctrinating teachers who can then indoctrinate students.
We've gone from the point of teaching children how to think critically to telling children how you're supposed to think. That's all this is, just telling children, you need to think this way, and if you don't, you're considered a bad person.
Fisher says other countries consider this type of education, based on emotions and not facts, a joke.
You don't see this going on in Europe. You don't hear them doing this in China, let alone we were already behind most of the world before the lockdown. Now we're even further behind. We're becoming a laughing stock of the world.
In addition to the teachers' union, the Seattle Education Association and Washington Education Association fully supported this event, according to Breitbart. I'm Bob Kellogg.
And that's American Family News on the Hour. I'm Chad Groening.
Here at KNVBC, we're very grateful to the American Family Radio for allowing us to broadcast their Christian news free of charge. And we encourage you to listen to this brief word from AFA.
Mom is a face washer, a coupon clipper, and a listening ear. She's a diaper changer, a laundry folder, and a mender of hearts. She's a master juggler of the jobs of the day. She's simply incredible and incredibly busy. At 1 million moms, we understand the hurried pace of the average mom. That's why we've made it so easy for you to take a stand against the trash that's in today's media. Visit 1millionmoms.com.
Good morning. This is October the 26th.
Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Ye looked for much, and lo, it came to little. And when ye brought it home, I did blow upon it. Why, saith the Lord of hosts? Because of mine house that is waste, and ye run every man into his own house. Haggai 1, verse 9. Many people limit their contributions to the ministry and missionary endeavors and call such saving good economy. Little do they dream that they are impoverishing themselves. Their excuse is that they must care for their own families, and they forget that to neglect the house of God is the sure way to bring ruin on their own houses. Our God has a method in providence by which He can bless our endeavors beyond our expectations, or defeat our plans to our confusion and dismay. Scripture teaches that the Lord enriches the liberal and leaves the miserly to find out that withholding tends to poverty. In a very wide sphere of observation, I've noticed that the most generous Christians have always been the most happy, and almost invariably the most prosperous. I've seen the liberal giver rise to wealth of which he never dreamed. I have as often seen the stingy, ungenerous person descend to poverty by the very thriftiness by which he thought to rise. Men trust good stewards with larger and larger sums, and so does the Lord. He gives by cartloads to those who give by bushels. Selfishness looks first at home, but godliness seeks first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. Yet in the long run, selfishness is loss and godliness is great gain. It takes faith to act toward our God with an open hand, but surely He deserves it of us.
Join us each day at this time for Morning by Morning, daily devotionals by Charles Spurgeon, read by Brother Ed Russ.
This is David Kuykendall from Rosemont, Minnesota, and you're listening to KNVBC Revival Radio.
KNVBC, your radio home for the old-time religion.
Moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
Oh, I have
sorrow,
I have woe,
I have heartaches here below.
While God leads me, I'll never fear, for I know,
for that
He is near.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. The Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
Every time I feel the Spirit in my heart, I will pray.
light in every pine. There is such gladness, and there's no sadness. For a light shall forever shine.
Singing and shouting, nevermore doubting. Love's a deep
love that's so divine.
Watching with winners, calling the sinners. Jesus is mine.